2013 marks the 75th birthday of the world's most famous comic book hero, Superman. And we get to celebrate with a brand new movie. I'm happy to say that it's pretty darn cool. I'm Keith Kelly, and my review of Man of Steel is coming your way right now. I'm going to fess up right now that I'm a huge Superman fan, and have been so for several decades. So, needless to say, I was excited when I first heard that a new film was on the way. I had mixed feelings about director Zack Snyder. I really liked 300, was pleased with Watchmen, but really disliked his visually stunning but overall crappy Sucker Punch. But the trailers looked promising, especially as they started to reveal some of the action sequences. The last time we got to see Superman on the screen was in Superman Returns, which was pretty lightweight in the action department and too big of a copy of the Richard Donner universe. I know there's been a lot of bitching about Man of Steel being a dark film, that Superman should be lighthearted and optimistic, that they played too loosely with the facts and some of the characters, and they get rid of Superman's red underwear. But if you've ever read comics for a long period of time, you know that creators are always putting their own slant on things, including costumes. And Superman hasn't been a goody two-shoes for many, many years. I've lost count of the times the comics have rebooted Superman. The only way a character can stick around for 75 years is to be reinvented from time to time, while remembering to stick close to the core of the character. Man of Steel does a great job of that. This is a Superman for the 21st century. We forget that all-American Superman is really the story of an immigrant trying to fit in. It's about being different in a land that's frightened by differences. It's about being adopted and wondering about your roots, about having the courage to stand up for what's right. And it's about hope. These are the themes woven throughout Man of Steel. This film would not work without the right man in the tights, and I'm very pleased with the casting of Henry Cavill as Kal-El, the ultimate immigrant from the planet Krypton. Man of Steel works off the premise that most of the world would be pretty freaked out if a superpowered being from another planet wearing tights and a cape would suddenly fly into view. Cavill's interpretation of Clark Kent perfectly externalizes the internal conflicts that such a potential savior would wrestle with. And he not only acts the part, he also perfectly looks the part. He's got the physicality and build that embodies the superhero. I like just about everything about the film, the visual approach, the overall flow of the storyline, and the casting. Russell Crowe brings the right amount of gravity to the role of Kryptonian birth daddy, Jor-El. And he's got more to do in this film than just pontificate. Amy Adams is a much more realistic Lois Lane than we've ever seen before, and you can actually believe that she's a Pulitzer Prize-winning journalist. Kevin Costner was born to play Jonathan Kent, the adoptive father of Clark. His heart and earnestness wonderfully grounds the film. And Michael Shannon brings extra shades of meaning to his portrayal of supervillain General Zod. The rest of the cast, from top to bottom, were top-notch also, but sometimes spread a little thin. Man of Steel was shot with lots of handheld kinetic camera moves, which helped add to the energy and realism of the film. The story was more nonlinear than the rest of the Superman movies, which helped with the pacing and unpredictability. The Superman-Lois Lane angle had a nice new approach, and we finally got to see a Superman really go at it with the bad guys. You feel his pain in this film. My biggest nit to pick was with the final action pieces, which were about a third too long and redundant. Part of the trouble with the finale was director Snyder trying to shoehorn in cool bits for each of the three main Kryptonian soldiers and for some of the other supporting cast. It added up to too much repetitive punching through buildings and not enough growing tension. But overall, Man of Steel is an amazing film filled with action, love for family, and true selfless heroism. It's a great jumping on point for those that know little about Superman and has lots of minor characters, Easter eggs, and set pieces that should thrill the fanboys and girls. I give Man of Steel, directed with passion by Zack Snyder, a grade of A-. I'm Keith Kelly.